Good morning, children. Welcome to class 5 social studies. Today's topic is the previous lesson, children. Actually, the lesson is over. Just I'm going to revise today some important points, okay, in this lesson. So here, children, the prairies are the vast stretches of grasslands. Okay, wherever you see, you will find grasslands only, children. Trees are less. Okay, so those regions are called as prairies in North America. Okay, in each continent they have a different name, children. So prairies in North America, steppes in Russia, pampas in South America, and wells in South Africa, downs in Australia, children. Okay, so mostly you would have observed that they lie in the regions of Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle, children. Okay, Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle. Another one zone is the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle. So you should know the degrees also, children. Okay, so they are located in the temperate zone. Okay, so frigid zone, torrid zone, like that you have learned. So here the grasslands are located in the temperate zone, children. Okay, so these prairies are located in North America. In this lesson they have covered that one only, children. Okay, as they are away from the equator, they have less rainfall and low temperature, children. Okay, so when you see the climate, no, the winters are cold and dry and the summers are hot with a moderate rainfall. Okay, summers are hot with a moderate rainfall. Moderate rainfall of 50 to 70 centimeter with a variation from year to year occurs in this region during summers. Okay, this type of climate is called a continental climate. The hot winds which blow during this spring is called Chinook, children. Okay, hot winds blow during the spring, they are called as Chinook. They are called as Chinook, children. So you would have learned Kal Baisakhi, no, like Lu, like that. Here in the North America, these hot winds are called as Chinook. Okay, and then these regions are located in the rain shadow area, children. That means they will not receive more rainfall. Okay, rain shadow area. Okay, and then next one, different types of animals and vegetation are there, children, so that the animals can withstand the harsh temperatures. Okay, the next one, the main important activity is agriculture, children. The growing of wheat. Okay, so wheat is a grass, children. Okay, wheat is a grass and it is called the wheat basket of the world. Okay, these prairies are called the wheat basket of the world, children. So that much huge quantity of wheat is produced over here, children. Okay, and then intensive farming, everything is done by using machines only, children. Okay, the activities like plowing, that is the clearing the land, and then sowing, so the seeds would be sown, children. Then harvesting, after the crop has grown well, we have to do harvesting. Then threshing, so we have to remove the husk of that wheat, no, threshing and storing of food grains, children. Okay, everything is done with the help of machines, and then scientific methods are also followed, children. Okay, so they store this wheat grains and all, no, in a tall tower like building called silos. Okay, in that they store, children. Okay, and the people who rear livestock, no, they are called as cowboys. They wear hat, boots. Okay, the way of dressing is little different, children. Okay, and you have ranches. Okay, where they rear the cow, sheep, goat, and horse and all, no, children.
that place is called as ranches. Okay, and then you have the ore crushing factories, oil refineries, okay, and then meat packing and flour mills also, children. As wheat is harvested more, no, so flour mills are also more, children. Okay, so this lesson you take and read, children. Already I have sent notes through WhatsApp group. Do your exams well, children. All the best. See you in the next video. Thank you.